one race ends, the countdown to the next one begins. This is our 7-day development cycle. Our team, as soon as we leave from Victory Lane, we have performance engineers that are analyzing data. We want to know, what do we do right? What do we do wrong? How can we improve? Artificial intelligence and machine learning is huge. All of the data that we have is being pushed to our crew chiefs and our race engineers on the pit box in real time. Those things all add up and can make or break your race win.
You know, by the time the planes land from the racetrack with the personnel at the track, the post-event report first draft is already out the door. In order to do that, we need to automate analytics. We need to provide in-race support where we're building the content for that report during the race. And then we wake up the next morning and we debrief all the information that we have from the day before and figure out how we can get better.
We take that data, we share it with the team. We have a race weekend debrief, which is a meeting for all of motorsports competition to come together and share experiences as well as lessons learned from the previous week for us to prep for the upcoming weeks in racing. Aerodynamics probably has the most impact on overall vehicle performance.
The simulation models at CTC are fed directly with the data from the wind tunnel. As each race team uses the simulation, that aerodynamic data feeds directly into where they set their car in terms of heights on track, which has a direct impact on their speed. We make small adjustments from the nose to the tail, and every little adjustment typically adds up to, you know, a good gain in performance.
When we find gains in the wind tunnel, we'll put those to use right away with, you know, sometimes additive manufacturing, and we can have parts on the car that weekend at the racetrack. We get together kind of a game plan of any changes that need to be implemented for the next week, and then we just try to execute those. So you can pretty much put it anywhere underneath the hood and it's not gonna melt.
The SPMM lab is our suspension parameter measurement machine lab, and there we are testing the track loads and how they impact the vehicle.
The SPMM, it's applying real live forces that we're seeing at the track. Depending on the vehicle weight, over 8 Gs, which is a pretty high force in a static environment. We've connected a dynamic arm, which measures our X, Y, Z position, along with camber, toe, and wheel spin. That data is then used in the simulation models to replicate how components change when they're loaded throughout its driving cycle around the track.
In the subsystems lab, we have our team of performance engineers who heavily focus on steering rack and hub testing.
We can tune it to make sure that it fits the driver's preference for each track.
With our testing, not only can we verify the performance of the component, but we can also run durability testing. What we're looking for mostly is the torque to be consistent for the driver throughout all the different tests to make sure that it's in the range of what they're expecting.
So we are trying to ensure that although our vehicles are going to change week to week, what the driver feels does not change. The DIL is the driver in the loop simulator.
Simulation is really the end user of all the data that we have here. We pull in track information as well. We have very, very detailed scans of the track surfaces. A large speedway is maybe about 800 million points.
Definitely feels better over the bump and off of 2.
In our series that we race in, we cannot practice until race weekend. So it's very important for us to have our simulation as close to real life as possible. So our drivers are feeling every bump, every turn, every twist.
And the whole principle behind it is you're trying to trick the driver's mind and eyes into thinking that he is in a car and it feel correct to a driver.
Wow, it's amazing how much that little progressive throttle makes a turn.
I mean, that's our ultimate goal.
I think I'm getting close.
Yeah, so the race development cycle is really ongoing. Depending on the technologies that we're using, we may be looking at the next upcoming race. We may be working 2 or 3 weeks or even further out on development, tire testing, track testing. What I will say is it's a constant development cycle, right? Every day offers a new opportunity to gain a competitive edge for the upcoming race.